At this house in Port-au-Prince, the chance to play with your friends isn't taken lightly. For these girls, this home is a refuge. Every young woman here was rescued from slavery, a practice still common in Haiti. Rose Murtha is a typical case. Given to a family and forced to work for nothing, she was often beaten and abused. An example, say campaigners, of a shameful European legacy.
It is not something that we want to hide anymore, because it causes so much hurt and people's lives, so we need to talk about it and change it.
Slavery existed in Haiti from the 15th century and was said to be brutal during the French colonial period. The Haitian Revolution of 1804 is the only successful slave revolt in human history, but it's a chapter that's far from over. This statue commemorates the first Haitian slave to free himself, sparking a revolution. But over two centuries later, there are still more than 200,000 enslaved people here. And whilst there has been some support in Europe over talk of reparations, many in the legal community think any kind of victory is slim. The reaction from European governments has been mixed, with many simply dismissing the lawsuit. Professor Erwin Stotsky has represented Haiti in the past and says claims for reparations may be a hard battle to win.
I'm a realist, and I've seen nations all over the world treated poorly by developed nations. And on the other hand, you never can give up, because small victories will add up to really a new national identity for places like Haiti.
But for Rose and thousands of others, reparations could mean a brighter future. And this teenager is already determined to make changes.
I want to be the president and to change the world. And I know God will help me. And I know I will study hard to be that I want. And I know who I am, and I know I can be the president of Haiti.
Whether reparations are delayed justice or a distraction from modern-day problems has been an argument that's simmered for decades in the Caribbean. But for these girls, the freedom to be together and be safe is all that counts. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, Port-au-Prince, Haiti.